November the 30th, 1887. Having passed through the Cumaean Canal, I emerged into salt-smelling darkness. A half-day's journey northward, though one could hardly call it a day in this stygian gloom, and I finally laid eyes on foreign land. His last known heading, I took a cab to the docks where I procured the captaincy of a sturdy vessel with an equally sturdy, if somewhat ragged-looking and melodious, crew. I explained my desire to find my father's stricken vessel to the bosun. The old man's gimlet eyes glistened avariciously as he explained the various expenses, even while the crew were already loading supplies by the crateload into the ship. Frankly, I was more than eager to divest myself of the filthy lucre of the Echo Bazaar. Quite unlike solid sterling, the coins feel greasier and more tarnished than even the oldest, grimiest farthing. I made to encourage the crew with a salty shanty from the surface, but found the words died upon my lips. It was then that the bosun stepped forward, his chest inflating before he began to bellow out a song I'd not heard before.
Heave, lads, we weary boys, to fate we're not but foolish toys. Truly stare with sightless eyes, you'll ne'er see the sunrise. Heave, boys, we doom drown men, there's crueler gods beyond your ken. Salt and storm we pray, don't cast your gaze away.
December the 22nd, 1887. Almost a month of searching has borne absolutely no fruit. My father's maps were all useless. Every landmark seems determined to be other than where they're chartered to be. I begin to see how even he, an inveterate sailor, got lost in this dark, forbidding underscope. As far as I can tell, we've passed through Shepherd's Wash and are crossing the Promised Sea, a bleak, vast expanse of dark water, much like every other I've seen around here. I fear that supplies are running low and fueled as well. But even as I write this, I can hear the lookout shouting, "Lawkins Port, the home of the one we seek," to press for further information. I have to say, I never thought I'd be visiting royalty down here.
Studied manse with a knowing look and a smile, and a promise that I would see my father soon. Food, fuel, all has run out in the days since. For a time we ate well after the chef found more meat from somewhere, but when I saw his smile all red and white, and the finger rings in the stew, we are adrift, becalmed. The drownies come again with their terrible song. They have taken all but the bosun and I and a mere handful of men. I can hear their bodies slithering wetly along the deck. And their song is so sweet. Their song is so sweet.
Toys,
to something from hash and strange. 4, 5, and 5 he lies. Those are pearls that were his eyes. Suffering he has seen change to something.